Hey everybody, welcome back to Stack Snacks. I'm John Swicky, where we try to make AI fun, accessible, exciting for everybody. So today we're actually going to look at something that's kind of old. We're going to play around with Notebook LM. So Notebook LM was announced back in July from Google, and it was originally called Project Tailwind. And so now it's called Notebook LM. And basically what you do is you feed their systems or models your own documents, and you're able to basically ask questions to it, right? So as you can see, here's a little taste of what the early UI looked like, and I haven't really played with it because partially it wasn't... The user interface was a bit rough, but you know, I was kind of seeing some updates coming through for the product, and I was like, you know, let me take a spin, let me see what's going on here, and it's actually pretty interesting. So I thought we can kind of make a quick notebook, and we can kind of see it in action. So this is... I made a kind of a test notebook, and what you need to do is you just need to add basically sources for it to kind of start learning, start feeding. So you can, you know, connect to your Google Drive. You can upload a PDF or a text file. You can actually just paste in text from anywhere. So I've got a couple PDFs. Let's see, on my desktop here. So let's just start loading some of these guys in. So we got PDFs. Oh, I don't think that worked. PDF. And then there we go. So one's a paper on large language models. And then the next one is a paper on Claude 3. And then... Actually, I don't have anything in my Google Drive. I think that would work. Oop, we got two of the same. And then let's go and look for OpenAI blog posts. Let's do some pasted text in here. And super alignment, sure. Let's do this one. Nope, that's not what I want. We need something with some meat to it here. Wow, I keep picking all of these short blog posts. I just want something to paste into it. Teaching acquires... Maybe this one. Yeah, let's just try that one. And then copy text, we'll paste it in. That's a title, GPT-4. All right. So we can, if we hit these checkboxes, is where we can start querying these sources. You can see down here the number of sources change depending on what you have highlighted. So let's just start with the Claude 3 one. Summarize Claude 3 models. So actually, so inside this PDF, right, they have 10 citations, and then you can click on each citation. It can go to the specific area where it started to take some of how it got to the answer, right? And then the cool thing too is you have little follow-up questions here where we can So we can ask, what measures has Anthropic taken to address the issue of excuse me, over refusal on benign queries in the Claude 3 family? And then we get kind of this nice little summary. So it's pretty cool, right? It's pretty cool. And then if we go into our other document, what are the best large language models? Oh, so you take little notes. Which is really cool. You see, we have a little, like a little note section right here. And then if we kind of go back to our window side. I got a little excited. And then from this paper, I asked, like, what was the best large language models? And then kind of went through some of these things that were developed by Google and OpenAI, which was interesting. And then you can kind of just have these conversations, right? We could save a response up here into our notes section. We could get the chat back up. You get the citations, which is interesting and nice and cool, right? Copy our text. So we could save that for later. I think it's actually really just a neat, really cool little tool. Especially if your data sets are kind of mixed up, it's not just a straight a PDF. The one thing I don't know is, and it wasn't super clear, the kind of privacy, does, you know, is there any training data issues associated with this? But, I will say, I feel like, you know, just for maybe stuff you have in your Google Drive already, where you're not too worried about privacy concerns, or it's not super sensitive, maybe. Google's already scanned the data anyway. Being able to kind of like take these snippets, paste them in, take some text documents. Yeah, I thought it'd be very, very cool. the UI's come a long way. Definitely could feel a little clunky at times. I think this is definitely one to keep, you know, kind of keep in your toolbox for different projects or different kind of things you're working on. You know, that could really, really be interesting, especially if it's a couple of different large PDFs. And I find myself using it for certain use cases now. So that's just kind of a quick look at Notebook LM. It's free at the moment. I don't think there's really a sign up. Give it a spin, test it out, let us know what you think. But I think it's definitely worth some time and some attention, depending on, you know, what you got working on, where you're working on. And that should be it, everybody. Thanks, everybody, and we'll see you next time.